In a couple of minutes, we continue daytime on 2 with Maths Counts. Daytime on 2. Now we're drawing the line to see if figures can lie in Maths Counts.
Like a change from tins. Have you had a hard day at work? Sit down, make yourself comfy.
All right, Wendy.
Feet up.
All right. What have you done wrong?
Wrong? Nothing wrong. Why don't you read the paper while you're waiting?
Hello, unemployment's gone up again.
Hello?
Yeah. It says that the amount of people out of work in Medbury has increased from 12% of the working population to 12.5%. Crikey. 12.5 people out of every 100.
Must be awful to be only half a person, out of work.
Well, it's got the actual figure here. 13,530 out of work.
It's more now. 13,531.
Is it? How do you know that?
Well, Steve, you remember last week I was late for work on account of all that bother with the Teds, and the week before that I was held up with Pauline.
Wendy?
And... yes, I'm one of the 12.5%.
Wendy, if you've lost your job, how are we going to live?
There are jobs.
Oh, yeah, sure. Says so here, doesn't it? 2.5% vacancies, 12.5% looking for them. Work that out.
Well, there's a vacancy in the paper on the back page. I marked it.
Supertex Clothing Company seeks sales and survey assistant.
Come and get your steak. Maybe your last.
Well, what's a survey assistant?
I don't know. But it's a job, and I'm going to get it. If I can.
Well, now, this is interesting. A nationwide survey has shown that 4 out of 5 house owners prefer Weather Seal for all-weather protection for their homes.
4 out of 5?
Yeah, that's 80%. The enclosed graph shows how sales of Weather Seal have increased in the last 12 months. Oh! Just look at that sales record, eh? They say every picture tells a story.
What story?
Can't you understand a graph when you see one?
Not always.
Oh, they don't teach you proper at school these days. You look at the line along the bottom, and those are the months of the year.
I can see that.
And then up the side are the number of litres of Weather Seal. Right?
Right. What about this line?
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that line, but it must be a good sales record. It's going up.
Looks to me as if they sold a bit over 10,000 litres in March last year, 10,200 by July, and then more and more until March this year.
Exactly.
This is winter. You'd expect sales of weatherproofing to go up in winter.
Well, of course it does. But look how much. It's gone up by 200 or 300%. You can look for yourself.
I am looking for myself. This doesn't start from zero, you know. It only goes from 10,000 here to 11,000 there. So it's only gone up 1,000 out of 10,000. 1 out of 10, that's only 10%.
Yeah, well, if you want to look at it like that. That's the trouble with schools these days. They turn out a lot of smart Alex.
Come in, Miss Austin. Please, sit down. My name's Blossom. Henry Blossom.
How do you do, Mr. Blossom?
We've only just opened up this office in Medbury. The company's hoping to expand its business in the area. It will, if I have anything to do with it. Now, have you much experience of market surveys?
Not very much, but I'm interested and I'm sure I could learn with your help.
Yes, Miss Austin, you have the right approach. Our aim, of course, is to sell our products.
What are the products?
I'll show you. We sell uniforms like these to staff working in shops, restaurants, hotels, any workplace where they have to be smartly turned out. They're rather fetching, don't you think?
Yes.
Yes, I'm glad you think so. One young lady thought they were too fancy.
Yes. No.
We must persuade local firms that uniforms like these are essential for their workers. Question is, how do we persuade them?
Advertise?
Advertise, yes, but we must back up our claims with facts and figures that prove to an employer our uniforms are good for business. That's where the survey comes in. How is your maths?
Maths?
Are you good at figures? As statistics, for instance? 3 out of 4 prefer Basho, 46% would vote for blogs, that kind of thing. All the other applicants had qualifications.
But maths? I'm sorry, Mr. Blossom, I haven't got any...
One moment, Miss Austin. You don't object to asking people questions and getting the right answers?
The right answers?
Oh, I mean truthful answers. Head office is very particular that we don't make false claims.
I don't mind asking people questions.
And if anyone should query the results, you could back me up?
I suppose so.
Yes, Miss Austin, I think you have the right approach.
About time, too. Where you been?
I've been, about that job.
Yeah, well, I told you you were wasting your time, didn't I? Dave said surveys is all to do with figures.
Statistics?
Yeah. Right, well, you can do the cooking tonight, seeing as I'm earning the money.
But I'm earning it, too.
What?
I got the job. I start tomorrow morning, full time.
What, doing surveys?
Well, first we have to sell some of the products, then we start the survey. He asked me if I know of any local employer who could be talked into buying uniforms.
Oh, you mean he's looking for a sucker? Who do we know that'd be stupid enough to waste?
You're a builder, Mr. Drummond. Your workers are seen by everyone who passes down the street. Smart uniforms are what you need to show what an efficient business you run.
Most of my men work under contract. They're wearing their own clothes, if any. I mean, what I mean, they wouldn't wear what I told them to.
Have you no permanent staff?
Only a couple of youngsters. They drive the van, do jobs in the office and odd jobs on the site.
There you are, then. They could be walking advertisements for your firm.
What then? Advertisements? Frankly, Mr. Blossom, I don't think I should worry about...
Oh, I think you should, Mr. Drummond, I think you should. Let me tell you about our magnificent introductory offer.
Offer?
Staff uniforms at half price, practically given away.
Half price?
Allow me to demonstrate. If you come in, please, Miss Austin.
Wendy.
Morning, Uncle.
If you move forward, please. This is our classic design for the industrial scene. Observe the clean lines and neat trimmings. Term, please, Miss Austin. Note the unique Supertex touch, this slogan.
Good grief. I like it. B. Drummond builds better. Builds better what?
Wendy? Wendy, for Pete's sake!
Where did you get that funny gear?
Funny? I don't know why you think it's funny. You're going to be wearing it.
What?
Excellent.
Excellent. 10 sets of uniforms sold. The first stage of our campaign is successful. Now we can get on with the survey. Here are the questionnaires. Now, I want you to go to each one of the 10 firms that bought the uniforms and get them to fill in one of these forms. As you'll see, there are three ways to answering each question. Take question one. Do you think Supertex uniforms are good value for money? They can answer very good value, or not good value. Now, if they answer very good value, you ring the A. If they say good value, the B. And if they don't think the uniforms are good value, the C. That's fair enough, isn't it?
Will they mind me asking them questions?
Well, I should hope not, seeing as how they got the uniforms so cheap. And I trust they'll give you the right answers.
The right answers? Yes, Mr. Blossom.
You can call me Henry.
Answer questions?
About the uniforms for a survey.
Oh, I knew there'd be a catch in it somewhere, eh? All right, fire away.
Do you think Supertex uniforms are good value for money? Very good value, not good value.
Very good value. I only paid half price, Willie.
Of course, it's bound to be. Very good value. That's an A. Have the uniforms improved the appearance of your staff? Improved a lot, some improvement, no improvement?
A lot. Mind you, anything would be an improvement on those lop-eared ragamuffins.
A again. Has your business increased since you had the uniforms? Increased a lot, some increase, no increase?
Well, as a matter of fact, there have been a couple of good jobs came in this week, but that's not because of the uniforms. I mean, the lads have only just started wearing them.
Oh, it doesn't actually ask if the increase was due to the uniforms. It just says, has your business increased since you had them?
All right, it's increased. A lot.
Again.
Any more?
Just one. Would you recommend other firms to buy Supertex uniforms? Strongly recommend, or not recommend?
Well, if I think they're good, they must be good.
Strongly recommend.
At all. Now, if you just let me get
over... Okay, we finished the floor tiles at Fairley Avenue. Hi, Wendy.
All right, you better get over to Fork Road. Ask Harry what he wants doing there. Tell him I'll be over myself later.
That settles it.
Harry goes into fits every time he sees us.
And Joe is making some very nasty suggestions.
Yeah, well, you don't want to
take
any notice.
If we're going to wear these things, there ought to be some money in it.
I meant to talk to you about that. What would you say to £1 a week each, eh?
It's not enough.
Oh, I think it is. I mean, I'll just take it off your wages until the uniforms are paid for.
Take it off?
No, he meant put it on.
No, I said take it off.
Take it off?
After all, the uniforms save wear and tear on your own clothes. Sooner or later, they're going to need replacing, and I can't afford to... What are you doing? Stop that. Stop that, lads. Stop that. What are you doing? I order you. Stop that at once. Come back here. You can't go out like that. What do people think? You... Oh, that's what I'm listening.
All 10 complete?
Yes.
Good. We're getting along nicely. But getting answers is only half the battle. Now we have to present the results so people can see what they mean. First, we'll need more figures.
More figures?
We'll award points for each answer. 10 for an A, 5 for a B, and none at all for a C. Reasonable, don't you think?
Yes.
Now, you've got 10 people answering each question, so the maximum each one can score is 10 times 10, 100. Take question one. This man thinks they're very good value. That's an A, so it scores 10 points. Another A, another 10 points. This one's a C. Doesn't he think they're good value at half price?
Oh, one of the uniforms ripped. I suppose it was too small. Anyway, he was very ratty about it.
No matter. We can't get 100 out of 100 every time. Wouldn't look right if we did.
Question one, 10 points. Question two, 10 points. Question three, nil. Question four, 5 points.
Very promising. You get a better picture of the results already, but it's still only a dull table. We need something with impact. Something that will make it leap off the paper and hit you in the eye.
Like a firecracker?
Exactly. I'll show you how it's done. There. What do you think of that?
Very impressive.
Well, it has to be. We have to persuade more people to buy Supertex uniforms.
At half price?
No. That's just an introductory offer. Question one. Do you think Supertex uniforms are good value for money? Score? 90 out of 100. Excellent.
But that looks as if it's 90 out of 100 customers. It's only 9 out of 10, that's all we've got so far.
My dear, you don't understand these things. The proportion is exactly the same. 10 out of 100 is the same as 1 out of 10. 90 out of 100 is the same as 9 out of 10, and so on. It's simple mathematics.
Oh, yes, but I mean...
And it looks better this way. 85 out of 100 think their staff look smarter. 65 report that business has improved. I like that.
But the man at the do-it-yourself place says his business always improves in the spring.
What's that got to do with it? Yes, we'll have this printed too.
We need a few more hard-hitting facts and figures to go with it.
Facts and figures?
More work for you, my dear.
I knew another girl who did your job.
Making a survey?
She came around to our house, asking questions.
Sausage and beans, Joyce. I'm sorry you've had to wait. There's usually 4 of us, but I had to let the others go tonight. Business is so poor.
Sorry to hear that, Mrs. Rouse.
I'm thinking of having an electric sign put up outside. Well, might bring people in. I'll fetch you coffee in a minute.
Thank you. What was the survey about?
Ethnic minority groups. Blacks, like me, or brown, or...
What do you want to know?
What sort of houses we lived in. I mean, in the family. What sort of jobs we had, if any. Lots of things.
Did you tell her?
Sure. She was nice. I asked her about the survey. It seemed there were lots of people like her asking questions all over the country.
Did they ask everyone in the ethnic?
Oh, no. They couldn't ask everyone. Only a sample.
What's that mean?
She called it a cross-section. Some young, some old. Some middle-aged, some single, some married.
So they're not all a fiddle. That's a comfort.
What do you mean a fiddle? Figures can't lie, can they?
I'm beginning to wonder about that.
Morning, Wendy. You've got the sales figures from head office yet?
They came this morning.
I showed you how to make a graph of them, didn't I? You've done it. Excellent. Oh. Are those the figures?
I'm afraid so. Sales have been dropping ever since June last year. Till February of this year. They've picked up a bit since then.
What about that?
Oh, seems the Northern office got a big order from the Blue Line Bus Company. Only one order, but a lot of uniforms, so it makes the figures look good. At least for that month.
Record's not much help for our publicity. We can't show people sales going down and down and down. Move to the right, Wendy, just a little. Bit more. Bit more. Little bit more. Sit. That's it. Perfect.
What is?
All we need, show, are the figures for the last 3 months. Sales going up, up, and way up. Splendid record.
Only the last 3? But that's not fair.
They're true figures, Wendy. Figures can't lie. Yes, we'll have that graph printed too. Now, all we need is a good sales letter to send to every firm in the district. Dear sir, let's start with something that will grab their attention. A percentage. That's it. You can always rely on a good percentage.
Morning, dear. What can I get for you?
I'm from the Supertex Clothing Company. You've made an inquiry about staff uniforms.
Oh, yes. I've got a circular. I've saved enough money to buy an electric sign, but now I've seen this, I might have uniforms instead. Well, I can't afford to do both. It shows you here how pleased people are with your uniforms and how their business has improved because of them.
Not because...
Pardon me? And you've only got to look at this to see how your sales have been going up. Look at all them orders last month.
Only one.
And it says here, 90% of our customers agree Supertex uniforms are good value for money. 90%? You can't argue with figures like that, can you?
Ah, oh, Wendy, did you get that order from Mrs. Rouse?
No, I didn't. Here, you can have these back. I told her to have an electric sign put up instead.
You what?
I couldn't stand by and see a combo that... Those lies.
Lies?
Lies.
How dare you? You don't understand.
Yes, I do understand. You picked me for this job because I was the only one without qualifications. You think that because someone doesn't have exam results, they're too thick to understand anything. Well, I'm not as stupid as you think.
Miss Austin.
You call this a survey? Of course they said the uniforms were good value for money. They got them for half price. And if their businesses did improve, it wasn't on account of the uniforms. That's not cross-section, that's double-cross.
I refuse to listen.
And as for this, it's a cheat, and you know it is. You pick the one bit that shows what you want it to show. Well, I only hope head office finds you out, because I won't back you up. I won't!
Miss Austin, your engagement is terminated.
Have you got that finished yet?
Nearly.
Where's Steve? He should be back by now. Ah, there you are. Have you got the results of the survey?
Yes, there.
Good, good. Clever idea, these surveys. I should have thought of them before. Now, are you satisfied with the work done? No. Are you satisfied? No. Are you satisfied? No. No. What did this one say?
I wouldn't like to repeat it.
This isn't a survey. It's a disaster.
Okay, finished. Number of complaints from customers over the last 12 months.
But it's going up and up.
You said it was a good thing if a graph went up.
Well, not that kind of graph. What's the matter with you two? Why can't you get the right answers, the right results?
They are right. That's what's wrong with them.
Why can't you be like Wendy? Now, there's a girl with sense. She knows what's what. She wouldn't make a mistake like this.
Hello, Uncle.
Wendy.
Sacked.
Sacked?
Oh, Wendy!
No, you can't be sacked because we've...
You said you wanted the figures.
We've got a graph.